Daniel, and as Josiah said, I'm a senior in high school. I actually just turned 18 recently. That's perfectly fine. So they asked some of the students, some of the members of the youth group, just put together a short little talk, just like 2 or 3 minutes, on how what in society matters to us.
Okay, sure.
Can I take this one?
Yeah.
So anyhow, these students in our youth group were asked to put together just a really short talk, a presentation on what in society matters to us most. And when I heard that I would be asked to speak on that, a quote immediately came into my head from the philosopher Andrew Fletcher. He said, "Whoever writes the songs," he said, "let me write the songs of a nation. I don't care who writes its laws." And that quote really reverberated me because of the extreme power, the intense power that entertainment has upon all of us today. Because entertainment, whether it be literature, movies, music, whatever, it sells its ideas and its philosophies to us subconsciously because it phrases them in such an attractive form. And especially with music, I view music as an extremely sacred, a sacred medium because it gives a path, a direct path to the soul. And if we're not careful, the songs that we sing, the songs that we listen to, can influence us, and we may not even realize it because the melody seems so beautiful, we don't even pay attention to the words. So, one of the important aspects for me as a musician, I play the piano, the guitar, the ukulele, and the penny whistle, in fact. One of the most important aspects of society for me today is re-influencing the music industry to compose music that is
hey, Mika.
And that doesn't denigrate human life, and that doesn't denigrate traditional values. And so I see myself as wanting to take music in a place where we express genuine emotion, but don't express gratuitous emotion. I'm not necessarily critiquing any particular style of this. I'm just saying that I think young musicians like me, and like all of us here, need to re-emphasize the beauty that is inherent in music. It doesn't mean that every song always has to be happy, but that does mean that the music we sing should embody those traditional values, if I may submit, those traditional Christian values of justice, reconciliation, and most importantly, love. Love not as a feeling, but love as a commitment. But for us sitting up here, just emphasizing the beauty in music, reclaiming that, isn't an end in itself. Because for us, as Christians, that reminds us of the transcendent, that reminds us of God, the beauty of music. As Stephen Curtis Chapman sings, music reminds us that there is more to this life. There is more than living and dying, more than trying to make it through another day. And so the influence that I see all of us young musicians having upon this generation and upon these succeeding generations is enabling us to once again rewrite those songs to reform our society and our culture from the inside out.
Hey, Eddie.